So movement disorders are neurological disorders that basically cause abnormal movements. The two most common movement disorders that we see here at the University of Michigan are Parkinson's disease and essential tremor. Parkinson's disease is a progressive neurodegenerative disorder, meaning that it gets worse slowly over time. That causes tremors, bradykinesia, which is a fancy term meaning slowed movements, and rigidity or stiffness in the limbs. Essential tremor is a condition that causes tremors in the hands, the head, and sometimes the voice. And the tremors in essential tremor are most prominent when using the hands. So these patients often have difficulty writing, drinking, eating, because the hand shakes when they do that. Deep brain stimulation is a surgical procedure where you place electrodes in the brain, and then they're connected to a pacemaker-like device in the chest. When you turn on the stimulation, it can help the symptoms of both Parkinson's disease and essential tremor. So in the case of a Parkinson's disease patient, they would qualify for deep brain stimulation when their medications aren't quite working as well as they should. They may have fluctuations in their movement where things are good and then things kind of aren't so good throughout the day. Alternatively, some Parkinson's patients have tremor in which the medications don't really help the tremor, and they would also be good deep brain stimulation candidates. In the case of essential tremor, these are patients in whom the medications for essential tremor do not work for their tremor, and so then they would be candidates for deep brain stimulation.
When we have certain diseases, the signals, the electrical signals traveling around the brain become disordered. A little bit like when an orchestra is first tuning and everyone is kind of playing whatever they want to play. What deep brain stimulation does is it provides a regular set of electrical impulses that kind of drown out that noise and let the natural impulses go through. So whether it's Parkinson's disease or tremor, deep brain stimulation helps with the symptoms by getting rid of the bad or disordered signals that are traveling in the brain. The first stage of deep brain stimulation surgery is the placement of the electrode. What's involved here is putting a lead that is about the size of a piece of spaghetti precisely into the brain, into a spot that's about the size of a peanut. To accomplish this, we need to be able to know where exactly where we want to be. We do this in a couple of different ways. The first step is to do imaging using a magnetic resonance scanner to get a very good picture of where we want to go. Second, there's an entire technology called frame-based stereotaxy, which puts a coordinate system into the brain so that we know exactly what coordinates that target is located at. In the operating room, we want to test and retest to make sure we're in exactly the right spot. The first kind of testing we do is called microelectrode recording. Microelectrode recording is where an electrode smaller than the DBS electrode listens to the sounds being made by the individual neurons in the brain. The sounds that are made by the neurons themselves tell us where we are. Next, and most important, is intraoperative testing. Everyone's brain is not wired the same, and so even if you're exactly where you want to be, not every patient will have exactly the same therapeutic effect from an electrode in that location. This is where having Dr. Chu and Karen Kluin come to the operating room for testing is so important. What we do in the operating room is we test each of the contacts of the DBS electrode and see what the therapeutic effect is and also what the side effects are of stimulation in that location. On occasion, what we discover is that the patient has side effects from stimulation and we need to move the electrode just a little bit. Deep brain stimulation is all about precision. Moving even a millimeter can make all the difference. The second stage of the procedure is the placement of the battery. What we do in the first procedure is we place the end of the lead underneath the skin. In the second stage, that skin is then opened and a battery or implantable pulse generator is placed in the chest, and a wire going underneath the skin connects the two. that second surgery is done with the patient asleep.
In the case of Parkinson's disease, when we turn the deep brain stimulation on, it oftentimes works in conjunction with medications. So patients aren't always able to come off the medications. In fact, many of them need both the stimulation and the medications in order to help their symptoms. And on average, we're able to reduce medications in Parkinson's disease by about 50%. In essential tremor, the deep brain stimulation can help the tremors so much that they don't really need to be on medications for their tremor.